Yep, that's me. You might be wondering how I ended up in this situation. So I'm training for a marathon. I'm 15 miles into this run. I have another 7 to go. I'm losing steam. My legs are cramping. I can barely breathe. I don't know if I can make it another mile. What happened? You basically need three things to run a marathon: energy, oxygen, and water. Our bodies mainly use the sugar glucose for energy. We store it in big blobs called glycogen that can hold 30,000 glucose molecules. Building up glycogen is the basis for carbo-loading, or carving up. That's when runners eat loads of carb-heavy meals, cramming as much glucose into their cells in the days before a race. Sounds like a great excuse to eat a bunch of pasta, but studies show it actually does work to increase your energy stores. Runners need oxygen too. First, you know, to live. But second, because it's key to using glucose efficiently. Our cells use oxygen in the reactions that break down glucose. Aerobic respiration, which relies on oxygen, is about 20 times more efficient than anaerobic respiration, which does not use oxygen. Aerobic activity, like distance running, cycling, cross-country skiing, has you breathing in a lot to keep going. Anaerobic activity is short and fast, like sprinting or weightlifting. Oxygen fuels our body's breakdown of glucose to water and carbon dioxide. Training increases the amount of oxygen your body takes in and your cell's ability to use it. All that makes for more efficient use of last night's pasta. When you start getting out of breath, your body is falling behind on the cleanup of waste products from burning all that fuel. That can lead to fatigue. As your aerobic respiration rates drop, your cells can only break glucose in half. That makes lactic acid. Now, it's a myth that lactic acid leads to muscle soreness, but the higher acidity inside your cells does disrupt biological processes. That's why your brain tells your legs they're on fire. It wants you to slow down and catch your breath. You can run low on glucose too. Runners like to say they've bonked when they run out of glycogen. It tends to happen around mile 20, which is when many distance runners feel like they've hit the wall. When that happens, your cells start breaking down fatty acids to make more energy. Endurance athletes who have trained properly can break through the wall more smoothly and keep on trucking. Hitting the wall unprepared can be dangerous. Breaking down fatty acids form ketones, which can trip a process that drops your pH and causes dehydration. And this tires you out faster. And then there's water. One of water's most important functions is keeping you cool. When you sweat, liquid water on your skin evaporates, turning into water vapor. The energy that water molecules take into the gas phase comes from your body's heat. That's how sweating cools you off. It literally pulls heat away from your body. Now, sweat also gets rid of salts. When we're glistening heavily, we can run low on salts, which is why sports drinks contain sodium chloride, calcium chloride, potassium phosphate, and other salts, aka electrolytes. Yup, electrolytes are just salts. Now, it is possible to drink too much water. When you drink more than you're sweating out, it can lead to hyponatremia, a dangerously low sodium concentration in your blood that can cause your brain to swell. Not good. The science is still out on exactly how much and what someone should drink while they're running, so it's best to use common sense. Distance running, especially when it's hot out, can make you rather thirsty. So if you want to enjoy the experience, make sure you take in some fluids when your body says that that would feel nice. Long distance running is really hard, especially if you haven't trained properly. But there is a payoff, and I don't just mean the space blanket and free food at the finish line. Some people may recognize a feeling of euphoria after a grueling workout, often called a runner's high. Recent research shows a connection between the euphoria and the brain's endocannabinoid system, the same one that responds to the active ingredient in pot, THC. Scientists have found high levels of a THC relative called anandamide in runners' blood after they work out. That leads to an increase of every brain's favorite molecule and the one that results in the high, dopamine. Some of us at Reactions really dig this distance running thing. Others, not so much. Are you a runner? Or are you more of a couch-based athlete? Let us know in the comments along with your other sports chemistry questions. Thumbs up and subscribe on the way out, and we'll see you again soon.